Alliances turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Alliances turn to pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Dazzle!
Team Secrets turn to pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds.
Naga Siren.
Absolutely, Paul, as we get ready to get ourselves into this deciding matchup. Loser going home, Blitz, the drafts, that first pick Rubick, the last pick Dazzle against or into an axe. I mean,
10 seconds remaining.
What's going on here? Break it down for me.
Okay, so the main part of this is you want to continue whatever happens. You want to continue to take fights outside your base. My microphone is really far away. And more importantly, you just want to keep pressure on a lineup that features something like what Secret have, which is very immobile. You know you're going to take fights. Even with the axe in the game, the Dazzle has some applications.
Alright, and again, to go through it again, why the EE Naga for this one? What does Secret recognize here, and why do they want to run with this?
I will explain this, because anytime you're in a back-to-the-wall situation, you will let your carry decide this hero.
Okay.
You'll say, okay. Because with the carry position especially, you need to let this guy feel absolutely comfortable. We saw alliances quite often. Remember whenever they're about to lose a series, they go back to that Loda Naga Siren. And I think for Secret, it might have been a little bit too greedy. I do favor Alliance's draft this game.
Oh, look at this wraparound. This could be nice from Alliance. Here we go from the high ground, catching out Puppy, chucking him back. Stun onto the Lion with a heal bomb as well. Puppy's gone. First blood for Alliance and S4. He'll blink forward. No follow through, of course, here, level one, but it's a nice smoke indeed from Alliance securing them that first blood.
Yeah, really good move for them to go all the way around, understanding that they want to get the high ground.
MV, RTZ. I got confused with the anime I'm seeing, but look, this man is a dead man. All right, 2 kills for Alliance. Man. What a way to start the game, and what the hell was Artur doing all the way over there?
That kill should not have happened. They already knew that Alliance had invaded their jungle, but they still managed to get it down. Man, this game has already gone off to a good start for Alliance. I favor their lineup coming in. I think this Naga Siren might prove to be a little bit too greedy, especially against the dual core of both this fan and the Lone Druid, which are very good at dealing with the hero. And Queen of Pain, of course, is also in a similar situation. They have this tri-core that scales very well, that deals very well with this Naga Siren. And already the start reflects maybe how this game will continue to go.
Well, the lane matchups as well. So you put Bulldog in the mid with his bear against MV Pylodi. I mean, I guess this is Alliance reacting to what Secret are going to be throwing against them. And lane-wise, is this going to give Alliance a clear edge?
I think so. Especially since you know for a fact up at top, they're going to go for the next heal bomb. But it's going to be quite difficult for them to get this one off. But Loda frontlining for them, not taking any damage. And yeah, laning phase wise, it does seem like it's gonna favor Alliance. At bottom, Secret should have a disadvantageous light matchup in maybe all three of these lanes, as Bulldog should be able to survive against this Naga Wisp.
Yeah, we'll see how well Secret able to play. As you said, riding a lot on the Envy carry Naga this game. It was just, as you said, likely to be his decision. We'll see if the confidence is going to pay off. Top lane, Artur coming in, zapping away the damage. There's not going to be any follow through. He's just going to focus on getting the CS up here on the top lanes. Still early days, but he's having a good old time here, thanks to Puppy.
The good news is that Razor is still very strong against aggressive tri-lanes. All you need to do is get a level advantage of any sort, and you can really start to dominate. And the lane up at top was meant to be aggressive, was meant to force this Razor out and try to get kills. Otherwise, you're going to start to steadily fall behind in XP.
Oh, look at EGN's positioning as well. And the Lion's gone. He's on his own here, Artur. You see, Puppy's going to start to make his way back over. But can he do it in time with a hill bomb? No, he can't. Another kill for Alliance.
Very well done by EGM, being patient, understanding that the Lion wants to go away to try to get that pull off, but timing was just really well done by Alliance, and laning phase wise.
Look at the mid lane. Bulldog, he's dealing with two of them, but he's 10 for 3 against Envy's 5 for 1.
Sometimes the lane is just being pushed in. Bulldog just sits back, waits for the creeps to come to him. Everything so far going Alliance's way. This bottom lane, the Axe is doing pretty well. I played this matchup before. The Queen of Pain can't really die, but at the same time, Axe should be able to get a good amount of farm.
I mean, this is gonna be scary for Secret. They need to do something about the way that this early game's going. There's Alliance at the moment, 3-0. Finding favorable CS in the lanes. It's a very, very good start. I mean, looking at the draft, you feel lane-wise that was expected with the heroes that they're bringing into the fray, that the Alliance were going to have this kind of superior beginning?
I think I thought that it was going to be just a standard lane setup where they would send the Queen of Pain mid, Lone Druid offlane, and then they would save tri-lane. And Alliance have completely flipped it on its head. No, none of three lanes belong where they're supposed to is at top.
Oh, not again.
They don't have the damage for this, though. They've got to be careful.
Yeah, with the Pilot Eye coming in, they're trying to turn, but the disengage is there with the Warcry move speed. Alliance are out. And at the end of the day, it's drawn Pilot Eye away from the mid lane. It's going to give more space for Bulldog in the middle to bully that E Naga now on his own.
And now you start to see, when you get to get this one-on-two matchup, Envy still only at level 3. Bulldog's about to hit level 5. Maybe if you get some roots off, as soon as he does, he has some kill potential in this lane too. And up at top, the good news for a Secret though is, as long as they don't die past this phase, and they play passively, they're gonna start to lose out on levels. And this is where you can really start to see Alliance maybe fall a little bit more behind than they would like. As at bottom, S4 is really starting to feel the pressure of Axe just running at him under the creep wave.
He certainly is, but at the same time, he's still keeping the edge in that lane. I'm with a slightly superior time with regards to the farm. The mid lane, it continues to be this way as well for Bulldog. He is doing absolutely fantastically here against this Naga lane from EE. And even with the support from Pilot Die, it just doesn't seem to be enough for EE to close this gap against the man and his bear at this point.
Alliance still putting pressure up on this top lane. Razor still getting a good amount of levels. But again, Alliance, they made this lane to be able to get kills. They want to try to find them if they can. They know that Puppy's there. They also, not having boots, is going to play a little bit further back.
Top lane, you can just see the positioning from Ake and EGM. Just trying to mess with the pull. Ping's coming out to Puppy. Loden wants to try and make a go. If EGM could get the telekinesis, try, but Puppy being very, very careful with the positioning. The ping coming out as well. They've realized that there is indeed a dire ward at the side.
All three of them get spotted out coming in. Even without boots, Puppy just playing that space game, and the Razor continues to get levels. You notice that he's going to be almost a full level ahead of Loda in this safe lane, and this is what we were talking about. Even with the two kills, you're naturally just going to get a lot more experience in a lane like this.
Nice for at this point on the bottom lane. He has got that level 6, so we'll see if there's going to be a point where he picks up a TP and he's going to be very ready to go for some counter initiations if it's going to be Secret pushing in. But at the moment it is Alliance, you know, they're pushing in on the top, mid lane. I mean, I'm still just looking at Buddy. He's now starting to see the gap between himself and Envy close up as Envy does catch up. But, I mean, Porto's got to be very happy with the start in terms of how fast he's been farming.
Oh, he's almost already got his hand on Midas.
Our top lane, they're gonna need some help. Io's coming through. Is it gonna be enough? With the stun, maybe, but already our top falling low. He's gonna go down. They do. Oh, he lives! He lives! They've lost EGM. Lotus gotta run as well. Finally go down. Arteezy, so it is a one for one.
Poison touch.
Only just though. It was a very, very close one. But still, Alliance, a support for a core and forcing out those TPs. Gonna be happy with the trade once more.
Yes, and this is exactly what they need to do in this aggro tri lane. Pick up kills, and Secret keep obliging. They keep losing their Razor up at top. Meanwhile, in this mid matchup, like we keep talking about, Lone Druid doing quite well for himself, and at bottom, finally Universe got sent back ready, and this bottle pickup, S4 should be a lot more happy about the direction of this lane.
I mean, we're seeing at the moment, you know, Secret just playing reactively. They're just, you know, TPing into the top to help against Alliance looking for the plays. When's going to be the point, really, that we see Secret trying to move in and trying to utilize just the front line of the capabilities of Universe on his axe?
I'm not really sure when the timing is supposed to be, just because they don't have the best ways to initiate a fight. One of their cores can't really get into a fight without items, that being the Naga, and even when he does have items, he's not going to be a space creator. But the rest of their lineup is a little bit mismatched in the sense that Razor wants to try to get aggressive. This is not a late game farming hero, but Axe needs that Blink Dagger to be able to open up on any of Alliance's heroes because they've got so many different ways to create space. They can blink out with the Quap. The Lone Druid obviously sends his Bear forward first to scout for things. And now that Bulldog has this Midas, clock to the Radiance starts ticking.
Bottom lane, look at this as well. They're bringing in Rubit. EGM and S4, they'd love to try and find Universe. They've got the Sonic Wave, they've got huge amounts of Burst. Universe keeping himself hidden at this point. They'll ping him out. They know that it's very likely that he's going to be hanging around. Sapping the HP. He's actually going to try and cut through the trees, but with a Fade Bolt to the back, he's in a lot of trouble. There's your Telekinesis to set up. The spin's coming through. S4 backs up. Is he going to pop the Sonic Wave? No, holds it. Feels that the damage wouldn't be enough there, but nonetheless, they do manage to force Universe back to base.
Yeah.
It would definitely not have been enough.
No.
He still had 340 HP when he was TPing. Good amount. They would have had to have maybe one right click each, but not worth it to use
and
that ultimate.
Very close indeed. Envy taking himself away from the Quap. But this really feels, I mean, you know, as we said and kind of expected, just with the Naga, you know, Secret can play that long game. But at the pace that Alliance is moving, yeah, Secret have got to kind of come up with some answers soon because already in the mid lane, S4 now. That Invis rune. Looks like he's going to make a journey into the jungle. See if he can find maybe one of the weaker heroes or... just checking out that there's no one hanging around for Secret, perhaps.
Yep. This mid lane is going to be very difficult for him to gank anyways.
Oh, this poor old Io. Die. Does S4 want to go for this?
Everybody's
is it worth it?
Though.
Yep. Why not? Easy kill. Easy life. And he's out. Oh, there's it. I mean, you're seeing Pi. Puppy
fast.
Coming around. Puppy can't get there. Okay. They want to use the song for this one. The lockdown
here,
that they've got. Dyer's middle. I mean, if Vakke gets a chance for Grave, S4's going to be able to have the blink back up. We'll see if Vakke's able to play it around. Where's the Grave? There it is, but the dunk's there. Of course. Universe coming in with the right timing. And they will punish S4's play for that. So, all in all, of course, not worth it there for the Quap and the Burst. As I say, good trade for Secret. Yeah, you're right. Bulldog finds the space for the tower. More farm for the Lone Druid.
That is a free mid tower for a Lone Druid.
They got a 7-minute Midas.
He is so filthy farmed right now. It's not even as if Alliance got nothing out of that. They were able to get a kill. And the tower is just kind of that icing on the cake. They finally rotate Lota to this bottom lane. He's got his Helm of Dom, so he's going to just continue to stack up, farm that area off. Secret are going to have to ward that if they're going to have any chance of holding in this game. Everybody from Alliance just continues to farm, and now it feels like the positions are a little bit reversed.
Stop, Puppet. Securing some of the bigger creeps here away from Hackett. Hanging about S4 coming back up to the top lane. A little different kind of laning now going on. We've seen Arteezy. He's headed down to the bottom with Pi. And this top lane, it's just going to be Puppy looking for the levels on his line. He's on his own at the moment. He's now got EE coming back up there as well to continue his farm game. So Vanguard now done on Universe. So he's certainly going to add to his durability in these engagements that the Alliance have been looking to take upon Secret. And of course, there's this very nice Ancient Stack that is being checked up upon and being given to Universe. So this man, 10 minutes in, he's got the Vanguard, 1k gold. It's going to be good timing on his Blink-Vanguard combination at this rate.
They really need him to have a good game, just because, yeah. Again, if you look at their lineup, he's one of their main initiators. You've got Lion, of course, but nowhere near the Blink Dagger. Probably not going to be able to get one for quite some time, just because this Wisp is playing a little bit greedier than Pileidai normally does, buying the Tome of XP for himself. On the flip side of things, EGM already has Arcane Boots. It'll be quite a greedy support in a game like this. Up at top, S4. Trying to get this angle going. Puppy does have his level 6, but...
We'll see if we can go for it, but yeah. Indeed, just keeping himself away. Eyes towards the bottom now. Loader and Ake making a move across the map. Universe fairly far down. He does have the backup of Aya. There is a relocate available as well from Pi if necessary.
This is not the kill that you necessarily want to go for.
Alright, we're Pi around. It's going to be an impossible one there for Alliance. So just keeping the farm up on Loader.
Ancient stacking begins for Alliance, and in that last game we saw Secret just frustrate Alliance by going for the farm, playing safe. We're seeing the exact same thing this game is. S4 just playing around with them at top, making sure that these supports stay up. Puppy trying to make something happen with his Finger of Death, but he's just continuously being denied opportunities.
Alliance just avoiding a lot of, yeah, as you said, plays from Secret very nicely at the moment. Universe coming back in for this small stack, but this will put him very, very close to having that Blink Dagger done. And there will be a lot of eyes on Universe to create the space for EE's Naga to continue. And we can also imagine that RTZ will want to be turning up to the fights on his Razor. And just use the mid-game power that that hero possesses.
Envy already has the drums. No Radiance. Not even very close, whereas Bulldog, 13 minutes into the game, almost already has that relic.
Yeah, this is ridiculous from the dog.
I think the timing is normally 19, 18.
Yeah, I mean, 19 minute Midas Radiance. It's like, wow, this guy's recovered nicely. Hey, he's had an alright game. You look at the Bulldog, as you said, 13 minutes in, relic nearly done, on top of the Midas. I mean, what is there? How do they stop Bulldog from doing this? How do they slow down his farm? I guess you are looking for Universe to find, make these plays, catch the Lone Druid himself off on the back lines of the fight. But he himself, he's going to need the backup. Alliance, they've got Ake on the Dazzle. Yeah, it's not going to save you against the Dunk, but at the same time, if you're not able to bring him low enough initially, it doesn't matter about that.
Exactly. And Secret, just by the function of their draft, they didn't really have the best ways to get into that jungle, get aggressive on Bulldog. They also had to play a little bit more passive with their farming because they've got this Naga Siren. At the same time, because of RTZ's slow startup at top, when they aggro tri-laned him, he wasn't able to get that mech. They weren't able to go for the 5-man push. Obviously, Razor not the best flash farmer. We're seeing it this game is... Secret, Puppy was trying to make something happen up at top, but S4 kept game sensing it, going back whenever Puppy would step forward. And so, two of the heroes that you need out of Secret to get anything done just haven't been able to get anything done.
Absolutely not. This is...
Like the support.
Oh, EG, oh. All right, let's relocate on the Rubik, boys.
That was fast.
I mean, EGM has been having a good start and a lot of space on that Rubik, because we've seen he's playing that greedy role, as you said. And he's been getting away with it until now. Secret punished that one. Now they want to look to try and move with this momentum and find more Loader. It's been a nice pick if they can get that opening onto it. And Universe leads in. They've got the damage to deal with this man. There is backup on the side of Alliance. He's not going to come in time. With a finger in the dunk, he's gone. Nice clean kill for Secret. Will they pay for it? Highlight eye there as well. Looks like Alliance. Still effectively two down. EGM's only just back on the map. Unable to grow back into that one. So Secret... just a very nice movement through the Radiant Jungle.
A death that didn't really seem necessary, especially since they saw EGM at bottom. Once they got that kill, Alliance should have had those warning bells go off because they weren't continuing to pressure bottom. They thought this one ward would protect them, but they didn't even leave the base area, so no vision whatsoever for that. Loda just continues to farm on the high ground. Not going to matter too much as he has that harmlink completed. More importantly, that Ancient stack is ready and waiting for him. They've got opportunities to grow here. The XP starting to shift in favor of Secret. That might all change, though, after this Ancient stack.
And what's the build here from Loader? Is it going to be the Helm, Armlet, and then Echo Saber?
Yeah, I think Treads, too, at some point.
Yeah.
Gonna have to grab him, but not really concerned about that too much. Secret do have pretty good ways to deal with this, and now Envy, at one point, had almost no farm, but his team has created him a lot of space in the last 2 or 3 minutes. Secret trying to get aggressive with that Blink Dagger. We talked about how it had to be this Axe that was leading the charge.
Oh.
Just run into some heroes here, though.
Yeah, but this is a fight. Oh, I guess they can bring Nagrim with a relocate, but straight in. There's going to be the Hex up, looking for EGM. The stun on tag. Okay, coming through with the Sonic Wave. EGM jumping to the front. They burst it down the Lion now with the dog onto his face. Onto Envy. They'll find it in a second. They're going to get themselves out. Now there's been a TP out for one. RTZ, he's not getting away as well. Only Universe to escape.
Envy didn't even get that ultimate off.
It's another one of those situations where Secret fighting into the high ground, and it just happens to be that the full lineup of Alliance are there.
Yeah, one of the worst heroes to run into that Dazzle is EGM just played them like a fiddle, steals that Lion stun, wastes so much of their time, enough for Alliance to come in full force. Now you've got the Radiance on this lone Druid. 16 minutes into the game, this number one tower up at top is going to be free, and an engagement that Secret did not really want to take, but felt like they had to get aggressive.
Alliance can be very, very strong here in game three.
This tier 2 tower, I don't think it's something that Secret can defend. Instead, they're going to go for the split push, play behind this Envy core, but pace of the game might just be too fast for a Naga now.
It certainly feels that way. It really does in Alliance. With this tier 2,
Bulldog is just so farmed at this phase of the game.
Yeah, it really is ridiculous. I mean, 3.3k ahead of Envy's Naga, who was being babysat by Pilot Isaiah in that mid lane matchup. It just goes to show how well Bulldog can play on this era, and how well he can look at a certain hero matchup and realize its strengths. Bottom lane, Envy does manage to juke RC off the Stormhammer. Will get himself out of there with the relocate top pie. He's going to be in a lot of trouble. He'll be able to get up the IO kill for sure. He's got the creep wave to go across to. Can't get him, sense himself out of that one though. Now another one for Alliance as they pick up yet a 10th kill and another kill. The Lone Druid is going to be having to his name, Mr. Bulldog 203.
They're just going to keep rolling too. This bottom tier 1 tower, it's going to be incredibly difficult for Secret to take this fight without their Wisp. And now they're just losing heroes across the map. They're losing towers to go on top of that. Alliance will continue this push because they know Secret have no intention of fighting it. By showing so many of these heroes mid, Alliance are just going to take another freebie, and that's only one tier 2 tower left alive after this. They pop the glyph, but it's going to be a wasted one.
It really is. Nothing to react to this one from Secret. And see what the plan is now from the boys out playing on the back. Secret. It's going to be RTZ Midas coming out this game. I guess they are planning to play for the long haul. They're wanting their lineup to just kind of sustain and keep the game going.
Yeah.
So Midas is the aim of the game.
He absolutely has to go for this item.
Yeah.
OD, just because he understands our team isn't taking good fights. I have to be able to catch up with a hero like Razor. So he decides to go for that Midas. Trying to keep up, but Bulldog has had his for a really long time. This hero just continues to get bigger and bigger. All these items start to roll in for them. The Orchid's going to be completed, as is the Force Staff. Bulldog has that Vlad's now at 19 minutes in, has that armor component that he desperately needs too.
So, I mean, considering the situation, if you are Alliance, are you on much of a timer, really? Are you forced to continue this aggressive kind of play? Like, how easy is it going to be for Secret to catch up if the game pace does slow down?
I think Secret are fine, because they still have objectives to grow from. If they didn't have any of these tier 2 towers, then I would say that they would probably have to get a little bit more aggressive. But even then, against the Naga Siren, Dazzle's one of better heroes because you can spam out, heal through the illusions, keep the push going, and keep the sustain going. And they've got a lot of independent cores too. They've got a tri-core that continue to scale. Like, all three of these heroes are really farmed. Like, none of them have really fallen far behind.
And we're gonna see here as well, Alliance going for Roche. And there's gonna be no response from Secret. Roshan will go down. AG's picked up by S4, so it's gonna allow him to continue to go for these big blinks in the middle of the fights and start off those aggressive maneuvers. 2.1k on Loda now, on top of the Echo Saber, so he's continuing to farm up a real treat. And it's it is Universe at the moment on the Axis at the top for Secret. I mean, this, of course, is, you know, it's partly down to the fact that they were giving him those ancient stacks. But we're yet to kind of really see the big defense from Secret. As Alliance push him, they'll find themselves yet another tier 2.
Bear's being sent back to base. Grabs that Blink Dagger now. Here comes the assault as... There we go! You saw the heal? Cancels out all the damage that that Naga was able to do. Now Bulldog can frontline with his own Radiance.
Oh, Universe jumping in, getting onto Ake. He's gonna look to try and take this man down, but the stun. Now with the telekinesis, they follow through.
That's a big commitment, though.
He just holding this off. I mean, Alliance now, they're gonna know that the Song down. Stick around and go aggressive again. Oh, did he? Is he got it? EGM? Oh, he has! EGM, he's got his own Song. S4 jumps in, bursts down the Axe with a Sonic Wave and Secret. This is a bad position for them to be in now on this defense. Trying to bend against a lineup that's already so far ahead. They've got the Song and your own Naga doesn't. And they'll look to find the Rax here. Alliance are now jumping in. Puppy, force back. They're falling low. It doesn't matter. Alliance, they found themselves the melee Rax 22 minutes in. And Team Secret, this looks to be a bit of an ode back to game one where it just was crumbling from the laning stage onwards for the side.
Look at how easy it is for Alliance to sustain. Secret are so hard committed when that Axe decides to jump forward. Can't really disengage off of that point, and now without that Naga sleep, it's going to be incredibly hard for them to take this fight, as I think Alliance just keep going behind the fact that EGM has his own sleep. If things get hairy at bottom, they can just pop it, reset the fight, wait for the Axe to run out, then come back in.
This is the thing as well, that the supports of Alliance, EGM and Ake, they're doing so well for themselves. EGM is halfway towards an Aghanim's. Ake, he's got a Solar Crest ready for this push at 22 minutes. It's absolutely disgusting. See what it got to do something big. They're coming with a call, but EGM singing an absolutely beautiful song. Holding Secret back in Alliance. Well, they're still ready to fight. Look at the Science of the Universe. Now bring themselves back. Loda getting fingered. Force to the side. Can they keep this man alive? Get him away from the Axe. He'll pop the arm. It turns around with the Storm Hammer onto two. Secret being forced back on the back lines. S4 jumps in. Takes down the Lion. They do lose EGM in return. Maybe this is Secret making the cleanup happen. They'll find a second S4. Down as well. He's got the Aegis. But look at Bordog. 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 He's killing them all. He's still alive. He'll finally go down, though. He brings them ever so low. S4, he's still alive there. Maybe he's the man with the cleanup. Can he get Universe? No. Doesn't quite have the burst in time. Envy only just getting away. The Secret do hold there. They will take the favorable team fight, but only just. We nearly saw the power of the Dong just clean up that whole entire side. He took ages for them to bring down.
Yeah. And the bear was actually chasing in with the Queen of Pain originally. Maybe if it was with him, they would have been able to grab some of these kills as Eternal Envy limped away, less than 100 HP. Axe was in a similar situation when he got his TP off. And that might have just extended the game and...
Secret are going to be so happy with that. We saw, 4k gold swing, and it was literally, if they kill an Envy there, then suddenly it's a totally different effect. But the fact that Envy was able to live through that all, really benefit off the back of that. It's holding Secret in this game. Still only just 24 minutes in, dealing with a Rax down. Yes, they've got the Radiance Naga to push the lanes back out. They've got an Axe as well, so their lineup very much suited to deal with being in this kind of situation.
Yes.
But they've got to take good fights like that every time now.
Yeah. All they have to do is continuously push out the lanes.
Yeah.
Try to kite as long as you could. You saw Pylai Dai do work there with the Wisp. Axe going for so long. Eternal Envy played that fight to the absolute limit, barely getting away from that one. This is exactly what they had to do. Puppy drags S4 deeper into his base, making sure that the Queen of Pain couldn't support the main body of the team. Alliance are still in a good position, though. Of course, being a Rax up, they continue to scale. They go for the smoke. BKB is now completed on the S4, so we can dive even more aggressively. They feel comfortable taking this next fight. AC almost completed on Admiral Bulldog.
That's going to be absolutely terrifying, pushing with an AC as well.
Maybe they would have actually liked to wait for that before. This is quite a big item upgrade.
There was a smoke. It was scanned out by Secret. They scanned by the Ancients, but nonetheless, doesn't matter. Universe unlikely to be saved in this situation, and it won't be. Find themselves the Axe, a huge component in terms of defending the high ground here for Secret, to the point that they may even be able to force out the buyback here from Universe Alliance. They need this Axe for the hold. He's got a huge amount of their net worth in for the team fight, so fighting without him is going to be pretty much a no-no unless they can just hold back Alliance with the use of the Song.
might just be forced to use that buyback onto that axe, and focus popped, and Envy looking for that sleep. Probably gonna try to commit the axe buyback if he was gonna go for that.
Murder's looking for an opening. If he can get that blink in, he's got the god strength up. Ready and available. Still 20 seconds without the axe. Loader looking for the opportune jump in. There's your weave. It begins to get the armor, the bear, Bulldog just pounding away the tower. There we go, jumping in, gets the stun onto two. Envy, crawled out here, alongside Arthur, get the telekinesis, freedom out, puppy, falling low, BKB from S4, he finds them, they'll get one though, they're found Loader in secret, hitting back, they'll look for S4's while the Sonic Wave comes through, it's not enough universe! Double kill for the Axe, and now he's going to move in for more. Now he's up to EGM, he's forced back into the base. There'll be a stolen back, he's caught out.
He just gets the goal.
Oh, EGM with a stolen goal. It'll be Iron Maiden, but still, it's Secret cleaning up another. They'll find a fourth.
Unbelievable hold from Secret. Pylai died, not even dropping there. Keeps himself alive for so long. Bates Alliance in. That call from Universe. That's exactly what they needed to extend this game and their tournament lives.
It really is. Look at that. Look at that indeed. I mean, EGM, he squacked it a little bit with that stolen Culling Blade at the end, but it just wasn't enough compared to what Secret were able to pull off in that defense. And this time they've got the AC, but as you said, with you can see those last two fights, if they did have an AC, you know, maybe there was a bit of it kind of looking back and saying, well, maybe they should have waited for Bulldog to finish that one off.
Yeah, they could have made a huge difference with that item. Instead, they decided a headstrong rush into it. Once Universe was dead, they said, okay, let's go for it. But you saw Secret were willing to commit to that fight. They were happy that Alliance were trying to go for the high ground. They were about to commit the sleep into the Universe flyback. So that you still have to be careful. That call is still incredibly strong, even with the BKB on the S4. Saw what happens when Envy commits the net. They get a call on top of them. They've got a lot of things that can go through that BKB.
I know, they need to be careful about giving Secret these opportunities to just take so much back.
All of a sudden, everybody has so much gold on the side of
Secret.
Look
at Razor, look at Arteezy. He's still a fair few thousand behind, but my boy, he's recovered from the start. You know, this man, he was not finding the farm at the beginning, but with the help of the Midas, now sitting on 3.7k gold. Envy continues to rack it up on this Naga Siren. And you really you can't afford to lose fights against this, against a lineup with a Naga, with an Axe. I mean, it kind of feels like Secret, they did draft for situations like this one that they're currently in.
Yeah, they were drafting to hold the high ground, and so far it's been pretty successful. And Alliance, they still should have been able to play those fights better. And that probably would have led to the game ending if they were able to get a second set of racks. Then you can slow siege behind that lone druid. You have a lot of different options. They don't have the best way to deal with these upgraded creeps outside of that Naga Siren and the Axe. But Alliance, now they're in a position that they probably have to wait for the next Roshan. A lot of their momentum's been killed.
And they're hanging around this area indeed, but as you said, I'm sure they'll be a little bit more hesitant on going in again. Universe, though, very close to having the BKB done. Arteezy with that golden flux, he's going to opt to go for the Shiva's Guardian on the Razor. So something else that's going to be really key in this high ground defense to make it even harder for Alliance to push into.
Yeah, old chicken's built on the Razor. Really like that. Kind of provides him with everything that he needs.
Oh, if they can get this curry, though.
Oh, they might have seen it.
Oh, it's got a lot on. It's got a lot on. It has got a lot on. Radiant's
top tower. That's the soul attack. Booster 2 from Envy.
No, you got it. No, no. They get this curry up.
They're trying so hard. It's got so many items on it. It might have made its way out.
I think it's safe. Oh my goodness. If that curry gets taken down there.
They're still chasing for it. He's got such a special package on it.
Oh no, no. Is he giving up? He doesn't want to blink into blindly high ground. Oh man. Keeping that curry alive, pretty much. If they lose that curry, I think Alliance just rush the base. Yeah,
that's a Shiva's and the Soul Booster.
For oh my goodness!
That was pretty exciting.
Yep. nice curry and micro there from the boys on Secret. I'll get it back. There we go. Items delivered. Oh, back into Roche Alliance. As you said, waiting around the pit, they'll find this and.
Ooh.
A very nice shiny rune waiting outside the pit as well for Loader. There's a double damage ready for them to just grab and continue this push. Here we go. Oh, I should get to give it to S4, okay.
He is
all right.
Not very tanky. S4, even with the BKB, could go down very quickly. Probably gonna just opt to hit with him instead. You don't want to commit Loader to these high ground pushes.
Well, I want to see the DD on Loader, you see.
Oh, okay.
No, that was my issue there. I want to see this man punching for millions.
No exaggeration there.
Coming to a patch near you soon.
Man, that courier, courier deserves a raise. Valuable goods.
I'll tell you, he's still doing well. I mean, EGM. He's 800 gold away from the Ags. And is this a good Ags? Yes, it is. We could see some very nice ultimates being stolen.
That Naga Siren sleep?
I can't remember the last time we saw an Augur Ags. That would be a very nice sleep. Well, what's the regen? It's pretty ridiculous, isn't the regen with an Augur Ags?
Yeah, it's a huge percentage of your HP.
Well, it certainly is. So we'll see if EGM's able to get a hold of that. Obviously, if the game's anything to go by so far, he's already grabbed one song, so we certainly could see that eventuality occurring. But talking about the Naga, of course, he's still farming, he's still holding, and we could see this is going to be a little bit worrying on the net worth. Yes, Alliance were able to create that lead, but the fact that it's stabilized and now it's going back the way of Secret, you know that Secret's plan kind of working out here now. This is Alliance really kind of starting to lose grip of the game. It's still by no means are they behind, but they are losing that advantage that they were able to achieve in the first 20 minutes or so.
I think they're still fine. It's going to take one more clean fight from Secret to even things up. Yeah. Alliance, you'd much rather be in their position. They've got an empty exposed Rax at bottom. They were able to take out that mid Rax. They still have the net worth advantage, but like you said, then the Naga Siren decides to get more prevalent the later this game goes. He's got to be careful.
Yeah, because I mean, he's Naga's pretty much closed that gap between himself and Bulldog's Lone Druid at this point of the game.
Yeah, and they do have BKB breaking abilities like that Axe. Just exactly what you need to hold in the late game. And Universe continues to scale. I really like his item build.
I mean, this
Crimson Guard and BKB.
This could be a kind of grab your pillows room for the long haul game, surely at this point, now with the Radiant Octarine on the Naga.
That's what Secret would like. We saw their average game time is so much significantly higher than Alliance's. Alliance prefer to try to play for the win. Alliance.
Yeah, that's right. It was a 38 minute average on games for Alliance, and I believe it was a 52 minute average for the games of Secret. I mean, they're saying that though, the win rates, of course, were not too impressive from both sides, so it doesn't really tell us if it's better for them to have those games at that pace, but it certainly shows you that at least they intend for games to be at that kind of period of the time. So Alliance certainly coming up to that point where they like to kind of settle the situation, and as we're saying, and as quite clearly is shown with the draft and the playstyle, Secret very much looking to take this one longer.
At bottom though, lane's pushed in. I'm gonna try to go for this Rax here. Turn in there now and Bog starting to run forward with that bear.
Now here we go, locking down onto the Baron Z, stealing the damage. He'll get forced off the way and Loader jumps back in. Focusing onto Arteezy, the tether is there. Fade Bolt, Sonic Wave, can they kill this man? Yes they can. One more swipe for Loader brings down Artor. Now Secret on the back of this one, backing up. Universe jumping back in, but already the damage for Loader with this construct. Even the Axe can't tank it, he's got to back up. The space is created here for Alliance as they work on the Rax. Can they finish off a second with the fortification out? And they themselves low on health, they will back up. Again, we're seeing Secret struggling there in that defense. They are unable to punish Alliance, and this time Alliance walk away as a full five man. No one dying this time.
Yeah, more importantly, they were able to grab that range Rax. They're opening up the map for them, making Secret have to deal with this, lowering the amount of income that this Naga can take away from splitting these lanes and pushing them out. And that was not a clean defense by any means from Team Secret. You saw how strong Alliance's heroes were when they both popped the BKP. Envy couldn't really do much but watch helplessly as that Razor went down in front of his eyes, but Aegis is about to be reclaimed, and I think this is going to prompt Secret, or Alliance at least, to push out this bottom lane, try to make use of it. They still have this DD on Queen of Pain too.
So we can see that from the graph, that just little fight regaining that momentum that Alliance had established so strongly earlier on. That movement upwards, and there we have it. They're ready to go again.
Only two buybacks available, though.
Every ult is up apart from that Sonic Wave from Esport. That's down for 50 seconds. That was pretty huge in the last one. He's not going to have it for this one. Envy now with the song, looking for the setup, getting Universe into position. He's going to look towards Loader. Bulldog is just going to go for the two of them here.
Again.
The follow-up call. BKB's popped. Here we go. But already the BKB's out from Loader. He's ready to fight in this one. Universe melting to the back of the concrete. Puppy will be taken out of the sideline. They found themselves too. Puppy will buy back. But now Alliance, they just focus on the racks. They've got to be careful, Puppy. Ball back onto the back lines. He's trying to blink, trying to catch out Esport, but Esport's caught out Puppy. There's a dieback from that man. Universe is also down now for 60 seconds. And Loader moving in onto the racks. Alliance at this point very much looking to knock Secret out of this competition and move on further in this bracket. Secret now down two. They've got the Storm back up in five. They need to hold this defense before the full five is up. Envy trying to get up to the song, but the roar from the bear sings a much sweeter tune, and they'll rip through. Arteezy's only just able to get himself out. And they hold this secret. The song, 20 seconds or so before the full team is back. Envy waltzing in. He's got to be careful with the fade bolt. Arlo, he's going to lose him. Mind him out of the Sonic Wave. Now he's going to get whipped. They're trying to fight. They need to kill Envy on the back line. S4 defines Pi. Envy eyes onto S4. He might just kill the Quap here. S4 healed up and he's gone down. They've lost S4 lives. They've got to get themselves out. They got the objective though. They got the racks. Envy trying to clean up EGM with the stolen static link, stealing Envy's damage.
Oh, look at EGM. The amount of damage EGM does.
I mean, the illusions. They will wreck him, and the secret, I mean, they hold, but at such a cost. Mega creeps are now up for the side of Alliance. 21-16, I mean, secret, they will continue to play and defend in this game, this crucial game where the loser will be knocked out of Epicenter. But at this point, as we've been saying, Alliance definitely feeling in the strong position.
Oh, definitely. Mega creeps up. All it really takes is one little push. You've got that teeter-tottling S-team secret just toppling over as they're going to go for a relocate play. It's mainly just to push out the waves, farm safely for Envy.
Yeah. Oh no, okay, yeah.
Get some wards down too, but... Oh, this position. This might not be recoverable.
The players are they're used to being in a position like this. You know what I mean? If there's ever going to be a team that's able to deal with this stage of the late game, secret can, but at the same time, Alliance. They're very good at pushing, and you've only got to push a tier 4 and a tier 4 and an ancient, and you've won the game.
Yeah, and they still have room to grow. That's the scary part.
Absolutely.
From Alliance. It's not as if they're here.
Look at Loda. He's walking around with 4k gold. He's not really got the flashiest of builds, but it's been enough, you know, in these fights. You add one damage item on top of that, and suddenly, you haven't even got a chance if you're secret in these game 5-on-5s.
Yeah. You saw at the end of that fight, too. It wasn't very close. That was mainly just Alliance saying, let's get out with whoever they can. Maybe if they took a 5-on-5 fight, they could kill at least 2 or 3 heroes from secret and maybe cement the game for themselves, but they said, let's play it a little bit safe, things out a little, and with the Mega Creeps, they have a lot of different opportunities. They can go for Roshan at their leisure if they want, and wait for the creeps to push in and wait for secret to try to get out. So many different things that they can do. You notice the Razor doesn't even push these creeps out very quickly.
No, not at all. Not at all. That's easy. Still 2.6k gold. I think at this point, buyback status is looking like. Can we check that out for secret? So we're still, yeah, cooldown at the moment for Arteezy and the Lion. 4 minutes, 2 minutes respectively, and gold short on Universe. Dio, only Envy with that secure buyback available at the moment. Side of Alliance, they're only short on gold. They find themselves a couple of kills in a fight, they're going to be ready to buy back and get themselves in a second time. With the Aether Lens, now Ruby, we're seeing EGM, he's got a huge shield of his loaded, jumping in on an illusion. Bust out. This is a really, really tense time here for Secret.
To hold every single side without getting anybody picked off. So they gotta form this tight corner around their throne. The Alliance, they're comfortable just waiting things out. They can just continue to let the creeps push out. Go for the Roshan if they want it. We talked about they're still grabbing items, still grabbing some farm. Roshan's gonna be up in a short minute. Much to the despair of Team Secret.
Alliance at this point as well. I mean, they themselves, they're feeling good, but they've got to keep themselves cool. They can't throw this one away. They've got to be careful about how they enter the base, and they're doing exactly that. We're not seeing any kind of straight jumps in at the moment. Just a question of when they do feel the opening is there to move in and try and close this game out. Roshan's back up in a minute, and I feel maybe if you're Alliance, you just wait for that and play the safe game.
It would be incredibly safe just to go for that play. Not a whole lot of pressure on them to end the game. They know they continue to get bigger. Team Secret, they still only really have this dual core.
And look at that. They're so scared to send out the courier. They have to kind of send the IO to take the Naga over to pick up the ultimate orb.
Unbelievable. It's that perimeter that Alliance has set up.
Yeah, no way a courier's getting out and then back into this base. Loda jumps in, turn onto Arteezy Universe with a follow-up call. They'll try and follow it through with the Sonic Wave, but Loda falling onto Fist Universe! He dunks down the Sven, he holds one, and now our Alliance, they've got to be careful. They've got to back up. EGM looking for the TP out, he's not going to make it. Envy with the net, again, Secret with the defense. Double kill for Universe. And again, I mean, we said it ourselves, but
Shouldn't they have waited for Roche?
Yeah, I think that was what they originally planned, but they saw an opportunity to go in. Fortunately...
Oh, is Envy finding more? Oh, Envy. On his own. Let's see what he can deal with. There are three heroes here. I think Envy said he walks in. Is he noping his way out this one? No, he's trying to control Bulldog. Bulldog will TP out. Okay, he's still left alone here. Puppy closing in as well. Oh, nice play from S4, making them fall for an illusion instead. So that will be that. And as we're seeing, you know, they're holding the base. They are indeed doing it. And Alliance, when they're back up, maybe then we'll see them go for Roche and try again. But Universe making huge amounts of plays. I mean, we're seeing just this axe. He does a hell of a lot of damage with these spins. It really does cut through, you know, the Sven. Suddenly, Warcry, what are you on about? Axe doesn't give a damn.
That pure damage.
It's ridiculous.
Allowing him to continue to scale. Like you said, the initiation by him was really good. Loda got a little bit too overeager. The rest of his team was not willing to commit like that. But with Aegis available, he can just kind of rinse and repeat. Still, that's a glimmer of hope for Secret.
A Secret can... I guess they can try and fight around the pit, or if you're Secret, can you just not afford to come out that far?
I'm not sure. That's really dangerous.
Yeah.
You could just have Alliance kind of pivot, take the fight. If you take the fight outside the base without that defensive positioning, it's really easy to lose the game.
It looks like, yeah, indeed, Alliance are going to get away with this straight into the pit. Aegis and Cheese here for the taking. Let's see whose way it's going to go. Who's going to be grabbing the Aegis? Who's going to be grabbing the Cheese?
Probably Sven. Give the Aegis to...
To Loda? Or Cheese to Loda? No, Aegis to Loda. And Cheese to S4.
Okay. That's not the order that I thought they would do it in, to be honest with you. I guess I could just pretend... had that in mind, but...
Oh yes, that's what I would have said. Good stuff.
I thought that they would have given the Aegis once again to S4.
This as well, this smoke. They are ready for Alliance to jump in. They want to find that perfect positioning.
So I want to come down to Universe.
And RTZ, of course, going for that full lightning. Base defense build. Universe jumps in. Pull onto S4. They're bursting down. Can they kill him before he gets the chance to get off the cheese? No, there you go. He's the cheese. Envy getting focused down the silence. He's got to get himself back with the damage to cleave. Cutting through the line of a secret. They've lost to one. They're going to lose two. The sonic wave from S4 catching them out. Envy. Holding him here with the song, he's trying to TP back, but S4 fighting through the BKB. Envy will just get himself back to base. There's a buyback from Universe, a buyback from RTZ. And they do this, there's no cheese now. But Alliance moving in onto the tier 4s. Universe jumping forward, but EGM with the stolen song. It's Axe as well. Heals are real. And Alliance now fully topped up, pushing Io back to the base. Envy cut in the middle of it all. Universe stormed up by the Stormhammer. And Alliance now finishing off the tier 4. But maybe can they kill Loda? No, Universe is gone. They'd love to. There'll be a buyback from the three of them. Envy back on the pitch, but it was a fortification. Can they really hold his team? They're trying to do their darndest. They'll look towards EGM, but they can't even kill the Rubik. Triple kill for Loda. Envy, he's going to sing his song again, but it's the last song he's singing here in Russia, because Secret, they're going home, and Alliance move forward there with a 2-1 against Team...
Goal series.
I mean, but Alliance, you really can't say it's just Secret not playing at their peak. Alliance, that game.